Next squad is Kyuchitsu with 6 maps. For 20 light. Old trees, plants. See, here's another example of split pathways, right? Like, I can go this way. I can go this way, and I can go this way, and then here I can even go left or right, but yeah, just go into the same area. But every path shouldn't have enough ammo. I shouldn't be required to first clear those two areas in order to have enough ammo for this area. As an example. Okay. That's the red door, the red key was literally there. That's interesting. To teleport me back, so I think it might maybe was more of like, okay, you've got the red key, now here's access. Like, I think that locked door was maybe more like to show off, like, hey, you've got what you needed here, now you can get out of the area. I think that was more like it. Alright, already another key. Going for the simple approach. Also liking the aesthetic of this map. Looks good. That's a green key. I thought it was yellow, but no. It is a green key card. Oh, that's cool. I have no issue with maps, with bots changing the color of a key. Yellow to green, recoloring and deact to replace text print properly. Alright, that was fine.
That was a fine first map.
Nice and simple. What's so funny, like? Lotus Island. Full image with the background from E1 is taken from. Oh, really? I'm really liking the atmosphere of this WoD. The green key. Would have liked a bit of a key indication there, but that's a minor complaint. I just like the... There's a lot of green in this WoD so far. There's a red key already, so it's definitely putting quality over quantity, I feel, so far. And I just like the vibes so far. Just, you know, nice little... Lots of greenery, you know, the trees and shit, and... Yeah. So far it's good. Oi, my key is escaping. Green torches. Ah, yeah, you're right. I guess they did put an indication, sort of. I'll take back what I said earlier. I need to open my damn eyes. Thank you. Nice! No secrets at all, though, but I'm liking this. Mechanical. Interesting. There's a dead zombie in there. Chain gun. This is giving me some 90s WADS vibes. Map is definitely opening up a lot more. Pack. Well, I've been in the red area. Oh, is there an area I've missed? Or have I not been in here yet? I missed that room. Barrels. That was alright. Map was a bit bigger than the previous ones, but still no real complaints. Maybe a tiny, tiny complaint that, you know, there was a lot of pain sectors to have to go over. In general, you know, it was fine. Water leak. The cracks in the wall. Got a constant feeling that these walls might open up or something with traps, like lost souls. But they're mostly just decoration. Thank you. some interesting looking thing. That's cool. Are those kill lasers or block lasers? Block lasers. Aha, he fell down in the hole. I have a feeling stuff would come out of the water. But no. Maybe this will open up, looks like a garage thing. Oh, did it open up? Okay. A little bit confused where to go. How do I get there? Oh, there we go. Derp. Well, this is just areas we've already been to. So I don't understand why it... Well, I guess just to block pathways. But now how do we get over to the red area? Parking garage. Oh, it's a lot more urban. Aha, 7-Eleven. Didn't expect this WoD to get such an urban twist. Bepis. We got the health bonus from it. The ref, or is that the same rocket? I think that was the same rocket. Integra Bank. Cute texture. Oh, light switch. Hedge maze. Kakos. Have I seen many Kakos in this world? This might be the first one. I like the little details that the floor is like dirt in the spots where, you know, behind the hedge maze. I also like that generally this ward doesn't throw as many traps at you, which makes it more of a surprise when a trap like this does happen. Whereas other wards often like spam traps like that, where every time you do anything it's predictable. Kakko got squished. Cannot grab the drinks above though. And the backpacks and stuff I cannot grab. Unless I'm allowed to jump. Am I allowed to jump? Don't see anything related to being allowed to jump. So it's a little bit disappointing when they don't tell you if you're allowed to jump or not. In general, I assume not. But, you know. I definitely prefer if you're not allowed to jump that they just disable the jumping. Clearly stated in the text or something. Ugh. Yeah, I mean, I think a player shouldn't have to go out of their way to try to figure out if they're allowed to jump or not. I think that should just be easy to figure out. I mean, putting a sound as the jump button is easy, or just removing it is an easy way to let the player know if it's allowed or not, and otherwise they can like put it in a text file or whatever. It's not the biggest problem in the world. Have a nice flight. We're gonna be aboard a plane. Final map, I believe. I think that's a bit stupid of a mentality to have. I mean, yeah, there are people who will jump regardless and will break the map with jumping, but you know, I personally play a lot of different WADs, so you know, some WADs will allow me to jump, others will not. I'd like to know, because there's also people who make GZ Doom maps without jumping being allowed. Like, I don't think it's that hard to just type it in the text file. Like, hey, you're allowed to jump, hey, you're not allowed to jump. Like, just at the top or something. Either that, or just disable jump, or just add the jump sound. I think that's like, I don't know. Like, if I don't know how to add jump sounds and to disable it, so if I were to release a WAD, I would at least put in the text file. Just like, hey, you're not allowed to jump, by the way. Or, hey, you are allowed to jump, by the way. Just to be informative. In the end, there are people out there who want to play it the way that it is designed for. Being communicative is always something that I'm for. Ports allowed for jumping. It was always agreed upon that since Doom doesn't have jumping, you should only know it when
It is using jump.
Well, that's just, you know, assuming the player knows that rule. Or, you know, that people think that way. There might be people who don't think that way. You can assume everything, and you can let people assume everything, but, you know, just putting it down, I'd say, would just be more informative and more communicative. And in the end, just the overall best choice. Like, it doesn't hurt to just have the info there, to just be nice and clear. The only reason I use GZ Doom is because it pretty much runs anything. Like, I don't have to worry about, oh, which source port do I use for this WAD? I can just grab any WAD, be it a GZ Doom WAD, or be it a vanilla compatible map. I'm just like, plop it into GZ Doom, and 99.99% of the time, it'll work. And then my worries are over. That's why I use GZ Doom. But it does come with the thing, like, yeah, jumping is a thing in GZ Doom, and yeah. Well, if the PK3 doesn't work with GZ Doom. Well, it's actually a WAD I'm looking forward to play. Well, PK3 I'm looking forward to play, I guess. A lot of pain sector here to walk through. I think it's childish to get pissed off about something like that. Of Alien Vendetta, Archvile. Interesting choice to warn me about the Archvile. Didn't necessarily have to do that.
don't see the red door. Plasm.
The house calls. What does it say, exit here? I guess because it was the beginning? This is the end. Thanks for playing. You're welcome. That was a good wad. Nice little wad. I will give this a... Nine seems fair. A nice little wad with six maps takes quality over quantity. Good atmosphere. No, good relaxing atmosphere. Nice tunes. And generally just all balance. Can't really find any complaints other than a few maps requiring you to go through more pain sectors than I'd like, but it's still a great little what. Yeah, that was good. That was very good. Good shit.